Good evening. Welcome to First Presbyterian Church of Highland, Indiana's service of worship for Christmas Eve. We are so joyful that you are here to worship with us. In preparation for this evening's worship service, I invite you to create your sacred space. If you are participating in our Advent candle lighting, tonight we will be doing the Christ candle, the one in the middle. If you have your artwork, get that ready. If you are doing so by lighting your own candles, get those ready. And speaking of candles, at the end of the service, we will be doing a candle lighting as we sing Silent Night. So I invite you to get a candle ready, or if you are a household with this type of candle, whatever candle you may have that with you. Jesus Christ is born to Mary, the incarnation of God, the incarnation of love has happened. Hallelujah. Let us worship God.
Thank you. Throughout Advent, we have lit the candles of hope, peace, joy, and love. Tonight, we light the candle of the one who perfectly embodies these four aspects. The source of all hope, the Prince of Peace, the bringer of joy, and the incarnation of love.
We light the Christ candle, the candle of Jesus of Nazareth, born in Bethlehem to Mary. This candle reminds us that God is with us, Emmanuel.
In the beginning, God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good. Jesus is the light of the world.
Come, let us walk in the light of the Lord.
Please join me in the call to worship, adapted from Psalm 96. Oh, sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Let us sing to the Lord. Let us bless the Lord's name. Let us tell of the Lord's salvation from day to day. Ascribe to the Lord, O families of the peoples. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Let us worship the Lord in holy splendor. Let all the earth tremble before the Lord. Let the heavens be glad. Let the earth rejoice. Let the sea roar and all that fills it. Let the field exult and everything in it. Then shall all the trees of the forest sing for joy before the Lord. The Lord is coming in the flesh to be one of us. Our Messiah is coming with righteousness and truth. With praise on our lips, and joy in our hearts, let us worship the Lord.
Thank you.
Please listen to the invitation to confession. In the epistle to Titus, the author writes, "The grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation to all, training us to renounce impiety and worldly passions, and in the present age to live lives that are righteous and just, while we wait for the blessed hope and the manifestation of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. With the assurance of this grace, let us confess our sins together. Please join me. God of grace and mercy, we confess that we often fail to embody the truth of the Incarnation. When young women are pregnant outside of wedlock, we judge and condemn them. When tyrants declare the need for registries of vulnerable communities, we quietly accept it. When immigrants and refugees knock on our doors, we say that there is no room in the inn. We praise and glorify Jesus to this day, but we would not have welcomed him and his family as they were in reality. Forgive us for giving in to our worst impulses and resisting our better angels. In the name of Jesus, Child of Mary, we pray. Amen." Jesus Christ gave himself for us, that he might redeem us from all iniquity and purify for himself a people of his own who are zealous for good deeds. Through Jesus Christ, Son of Mary, we are forgiven. Hallelujah. Thanks be to God. As we prepare to hear God's word, please join me in the prayer for illumination. Guide us, O God, by your word and Holy Spirit, that in your light we may see light, in your truth find freedom, and in your will discover peace. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our first scripture reading this evening comes to us from the Old Testament prophet Isaiah, chapter 9, verses 2 through 7. "The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this."
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration, and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
There were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors."
Thank you.
When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them.
What child is this who lay to rest on Mary's lap is sleeping, whom angels greet with anthems sweet, while shepherds watch are keeping? This is Christ the King, whom shepherds, God, and angels sing. Haste, haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the Son of Mary. Why lies he in such mean estate, where ox and ass are feeding? Good Christian, fear for sinners here, the silent word is pleading. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste, haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the Son of Mary. So bring him incense, gold, and myrrh, come one and all to own him, the King of Kings salvation brings. Let loving hearts enthrone him. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste, haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the Son of Mary.
Let us pray. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. In this beautiful space that is our sanctuary, in the beautiful space that is our homes, and in the beautiful space that is our hearts, on this beautiful Christmas Eve. Guide us by your word and wisdom as we listen this night. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of Mary, the incarnation of love, we pray. Amen. Today's sermon is entitled Incarnation. Throughout my blessed, beautiful time as your pastor, I have had the joy of celebrating two Christmas Eves with you. Tonight makes three. And what a Christmas Eve this is! As with the rest of the year, it is like nothing any of us has ever known. We are physically apart from each other. We are worshiping in the warmth and glow of our own homes instead of the warmth and glow of our sanctuary. Many of us face the prospect of celebrating Christmas tomorrow away from our loved ones. And it is extraordinarily hard. If we take a moment and breathe the Holy Spirit, do it. Really breathe in and breathe out with intention. We can grasp that even though it is extraordinarily hard, it is also extraordinarily beautiful. For no matter what has happened, no matter what is happening, Christmas always has been, still is, and always will be a celebration of the incarnation of God. A celebration of the incarnation of love. And so, as has become our tradition together, I share the stunning poetry of creation and incarnation. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The Word was with God in the beginning. When God began to create the heavens and the earth was a formless void. Darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning. And God said, "Let there be a dome in the midst of the waters, and let it separate the waters from the waters." So God made the dome and separated the waters that were under the dome from the waters that were above the dome, and it was so. And God called that dome the sky. And God said, "Let the waters under the sky be gathered together into one place, and let dry land appear." And it was so. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let the earth put forth vegetation, plants yielding seed, and fruit trees of every kind on earth that bear fruit with the seed in it." And it was so. The earth brought forth vegetation, plants yielding seed of every kind, and trees of every kind bearing fruit with the seed in it, and God saw that it was good. And God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate the day from the night, and let them be for signs and for seasons and for days and years. And let them be lights in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth." And it was so. God made the two great lights, the greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night, and the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. And God said, "Let the waters bring forth swarms of living creatures, and let birds fly above the earth across the dome of the sky." And God said, "Let the earth bring forth living creatures of every kind, cattle and creeping things, and wild animals of the earth of every kind." And it was so. Then God said, let us make humankind in our image, according to our likeness. Everything came into being through the Word, and without the Word, nothing came into being. What came into being through the Word was life. And the life was the light for all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness doesn't extinguish the light. So, why the creation story? You see, the story of Christmas is the story of the incarnation. Incarnation means embodiment, means taking on human flesh, means becoming human. Tonight, on this eve of the celebration of the birth of Jesus to Mary, I want us all to try to grasp the magnitude of what really happened. The Son, a person of the triune God, and thus God, God's very self, became a human in every way, from start to finish. Conception, development in a mother's womb, birth, childhood, adolescence, adulthood, and death. And on Christmas, we celebrate the decisive entry of God in the flesh into the world. While they were in Bethlehem, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. That, my friends, is how it happened. The God who made the universes and the galaxies and the stars and the planets and the moons and the biospheres and the ecosystems, the great God of all the cosmos, this very God was born in a manger in a cave in the little town of Bethlehem, where there was no room in the inn. The God who set all things into motion with perfect algorithms, physics, and metaphysics was still just barely scratching the surface of understanding. This very God was born to the poor Jewish teenager Mary, whom we honored on Sunday. The God who dwells in eternity, who was and is to come, this very God was born in a colonized land to a subjugated people at the time of one of the most powerful, violent empires the world has ever known. The author of life, the creator of everything, was born in the most humble of ways to the most oppressed of human beings at the most dangerous of times. This was not accidental. I mean, we are talking about the originator of all things here. This was a choice. This was an intentional incarnation. And any time we see the intentional action of God, we must pay attention to the meaning behind it. By developing in a mother's womb and going through the process of birth and the life stage of infancy, God came to know what it means to be fully dependent on another being. And God forever proclaimed that there is divinity in babies and children. By being born into poverty, God came to know the reality of the vast majority of the world, their suffering, their resilience, their struggling, their strength. And God forever proclaimed that there is divinity in the poor. By being born into a subjugated people group, God came to know what it's like to experience violence in all its ugly forms. Structural, communal, and interpersonal. And God forever proclaimed that there is divinity in the victims and survivors. And by being born to Mary, God came to know the most important thing of all. God came to know unconditional love, that manifestation of God's image that God had placed in us at the very beginning. And God forever proclaimed that there is divinity in our love for each other. Incarnation. This is the Christmas message. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen His glory. The glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. Amen.
Please join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. A child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. He is the Word made flesh, the Son of God, the Child of Mary, Jesus of Nazareth, the Light of the world. Let us be the bearers of that light.
Still the Nacht, heilige Nacht, alles schlaft, eins am Wacht, nur das treute Hoch heilige Paar. Holder Babe im lachigen Haar. Schlaf in himmlische Ruh. Schlaf in himmlische Ruh. Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender. And mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace. Silent night, holy night, shepherds quail. Night, holy night, one.
Loved ones, as we stay in this night, as we rest before tomorrow's joyful celebration of the coming of Jesus of Nazareth, the child of Mary, may we have hope from the source of all hope. May we have peace from the Prince of Peace. May we have joy from the giver of joy. May we have love from the incarnation of love. We stay in the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit now and forevermore. Come. Let us walk in the light of the Lord. Amen.